Hello, and welcome to this Thought for the Day. Let me take you back about 40 years to a lovely summer's day, very, very hot, and I drove to my parents' house, knowing they'd be out working in the garden. So I drove round to the back of the house, reversed into the place where I would normally park. And as I was reversing, there was a bump, and I thought, oh dear, I've gone over something. So I eased the car forward, got out to investigate, went round to the back of the car and had a look around, expecting to see a spade or a shovel. But all that was sitting on the tarmac was this, a china cup. So I had a good look at it, no cracks, no chips. It was fully intact. And I couldn't believe that this is what would have caused the bump. So I looked again at the tarmac, and there in the tarmac was an imprint, circular in shape, that matched exactly the base of the china cup. And who would believe that I'd driven over a china cup and I hadn't broken it? But the mark was there in the tarmac. Thinking about leaving a mark takes us to Jesus, who left his mark in so many ways so that we would believe and trust in him. As we approach Lent and Easter, we turn to the cross and all that it stands for in our lives. Yes, there was Thomas who had his doubts. However, he allowed Jesus to bring him to belief. In John 20, Jesus says, "Because you have seen me, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed." We have all the proof we need in the words of the Bible and the testimony of believers. Again, in John 20, we read, "These are written that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that by believing you may have life in his name." We can also see Jesus in the lives of so many around us. Dave reminded us on Sunday's YouTube service that Lent is less about giving things up, but more about taking things up in the mantle of love, showing the love of Jesus, making a mark to let others know that Jesus is real. Thank you for listening, and I leave you with the uplifting words of that lovely hymn, "Great is Thy Faithfulness."
Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not thy compassions, they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever will be. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Summer and winter, springtime and harvest, sun, moon, and stars in their courses. Join with all nature in manifold witness to thy. kindness, mercy, and love. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Pardon for sin and a peace that endures. Thine own dear presence to cheer and to guide. Strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow. Blessings all mine with 10,000 beside. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great